Happy Monday mga ka-Itulay. Okay, so welcome po sa ating General Biology 2 Itulay online tutorial. Again, ako po si Tutor Tina from SDO Pasig. Hello sa aking partner, Tutor Easter. Kamusta po?
Hello, Tutor Tina. Isang mapagpalang hapon po sa ating mga ka-Itulay at sa ating mga BioStar students at mga partner school and teachers. Ako po si Tutor Easter from Horacio de la Costa High School. Good afternoon.
Okay. So today po is May 23 and nasa week 4 na po tayo ng ating aralin. So for this week, ang pag-uusapan po natin another organ system. So we'll be talking about chemical and nervous control. Okay, so bago tayo magsimula no, Tutor Easter, sineselebrate pala natin ang Biodiversity Day.
Oo, Tutor Tina. So kung ng isang linggo ay sineselebrate natin ang International Family, a day with the family. Ngayon naman ay sineselebrate natin ang Biodiversity Day. So ano bang ibig sabihin nun, Tutor Tina? Tayo ay nasa iisang biodiversity lang. We are interconnected with one biodiversity. So tayo, ikaw, ako, tayo, tayong lahat ay may responsibilidad na mangalaga sa ating kapaligiran. So let's do our share to nurture our Mother Earth.
Okay, ayan. So thank you naman, Tutor Easter. So bago tayo magsimula, no, again, ang ating usual reminder na i-discuss na rin at sinabi na rin ni Kap Munch kanina. So ready with our pen and paper and our gadgets and of course, ready to listen and to learn this afternoon.
At para sa attendance check natin, Tutor Tina, ay i-type natin ang mga BioStar students. I-type natin ang ating mga pangalan, grade and section, school and location, at name ng inyong mga bio teacher. At huwag kalimutan na i-share ang ating live stream at maging respectful po sa ating mga comments sa ating chat box o okay. Comment box.
Yes, so dapat i-share natin ito. Kung nanonood man kayo sa Facebook o sa YouTube, paki-share para mas marami pa tayo maitulay, okay, so at matutunan ngayong linggo. Okay, so para sa ating bioactive school, last week, Tutor Easter, so we have Padre Garcia National High School with Ma'am Ladeline Ducay. We have Jones Rural School, Ma'am Cheryl Gumpal Reyes. We have from Daniel R. Aguinaldo National High School, Ma'am Jen Melendres Pipito. We also have from Novaliches High School, Ma'am Jeanette Tamse. Horacio de la Costa Senior High School, our very own Tutor Easter. And from Lorenzo S. Sarmiento Senior National High School, Ma'am Noraida A. Sally. We also have Sir Jerwin, laging nanonood yan sa atin, from Marawi Integrated National High School, San Mariano National High School, Mr. Nolly L. Balbin, and from San Lorenzo Ruiz Senior High School, yours truly.
At para naman sa ating mga BioStar Students of the Week, ito po ang mga BioStar Students. Kier Cantero, Amar Sally, Hannah Del Rosario, Mary Anting, Gemuel Enriquez, Edinburgh Riol, Mina Ebora, Michael Jake Lutiva, Bianca Toting, Ivan De Lunas, Allen De Jesus, Angelica Gatiayon, Norin Agustin, Kent Bayantano, and Christine Mantos. Congratulations, BioStar students! So ipagpatuloy ang ating pagiging aktibo sa ating mga session.
Yes, tama. And congratulations and thank you sa pag-support since general at since third quarter pa lang, di ba? Okay, so punta naman tayo ngayon sa ating recap. So last time, diniscuss sa atin ni Tutor Easter about circulation, transport and circulation. So today, tingnan natin kung naaalala pa ng ating mga BioStar student ang parts of the heart. Okay, so let's start number one. So ano kaya ang part na ito? So we have letter A, inferior vena cava, B, pulmonary vein, C, left ventricle, D, right atrium, or E, aorta. Okay, so BioStar students, type the number and then your answer. Just type the letter.
So we have an answer here from Elena Remorosa, letter E. Pierre Cantero, letter E. Bayan, letter E. Villan, Mr. Villanueva, letter E, Daishi Vallejo, letter E, all of that, answer to 13 na letter E. Ano
yes,
po ba ang tamang
natin.
Sagot?
Okay, the correct answer is yes, letter E. Ang gagaling, naalala pa. Let's have number 2, tutor Easter, this part, ano kaya? So, we have letter A to D na lang ang choices. Ano kaya yung part na yan? So, by star student, type number 2 and then the letter of your answer.
Okay, by star students, please type your answer in number 2. What is the answer in number 2? So, we have an answer here from Elena Ramorosa, letter B.
Okay,
Mr. Bayan, letter B.
Okay, let's see the correct answer.
Letter B, yan.
Okay, it's letter B, pulmonary vein. Let's have number 3. Okay, what do you call this part of the heart? So, we have A, C, and D for the choices. Okay, by star students, what's your answer?
Type letter, the letter of your answer in question number 3. So, we have an answer here from Mr. Jerwin Sandoval, letter D. Frances, letter D. So, answer nila, letter D, tutor Tina.
Okay, correct. It's right, the atrium. And let's have number 4. Okay, so, ano naman kaya ang tawag dyan sa part na yan? So, we only have A and C.
Okay, bias test students, what is your answer in number 4? So, from Miss Binyas, letter C. From Elena, letter A. So, what is the answer?
Okay, let's see. The correct answer is letter A, inferior vena cava. And of course, number 5.
So, what is your answer, bias test students, in number 5? Type your letter of your answer. So, we have an answer here, Miss Sapanta, letter C.
Of course, it's letter C, the left ventricle. Okay, very good ang ating mga bi-star students. Tutor Easter, so talagang nakinig sila sa iyong discussion last week. So, for this week, ano nga ba ang ating most essential learning competency, Tutor Easter?
So, our most essential learning competency, mga bi-star students, is to compare and contrast the following processes in plants and animals. So, what system will be going to compare and contrast? It is the chemical and nervous control of both plants and animals.
Okay, so let's start. So, yan. Okay, so do you know these characters, bi-star students? Eh, kung alam nga, pakitype nga sa ating comment section. Eh, kung sino-sino sila. Ayan.
So, mga bi-star students, ano po ba mga pangalan ng mga character na nandyan sa ating screen? Wow, meron dito. Answer by Mr. Austin. Joy, sadness, disgust, fear, and anger. So, ito ba yung character daw sa Inside Out, Tutor Tina?
Yes, correct, Tutor Easter. So, these are the different emotions in the movie Inside Out. Yes, correct. From Austin, we have sadness, we have disgust, joy, fear, and anger. Na emotion daw yan, different emotion daw yan, nung main character in the movie Inside Out, which is si Riley. Okay, so the sense of warm, the childhood memories, our perception in terms of taste, smell, sound that we hear, and all the important activities pa no, na nangyayari. Let's say ngayon, habang nakaupo kayo or nakahiga, and then listening, and then processing kung ano yung mga naririnig at natututunan nyo this afternoon. All these things are regulated with this organ system that we're going to discuss today, which is the nervous system. Okay, so the nervous system is, the main function of our nervous system is to allow rapid communication of the different organs, okay, and then to the external environment. So, halimbawa, may ma-detect man na any changes in the surroundings, it will respond immediately to keep the processes na meron tayo sa katawan in balance. So let's say, for example, the temperature, the ion balance, the glucose level. So para i-attain niya yung optimal level. And our nervous system, so for this part, no, Tutor Easter, we're going to focus first on the nervous system of vertebrates, and then later on, i-compare natin siya with invertebrates. So the nervous system can be divided into two major divisions. We have the central nervous system, which is referred to as central because it gathers all the information. Which is received from all parts of the body, and then it will coordinate with a certain response. Okay, and the other division is said to be, or it is known to be, peripheral nervous system. So it consists of the nerves that branch out from the brain and spinal cord, forms the communication network between the central nervous system, or our CNS, and the other parts of the body. So, tingnan muna natin yung central nervous system. Okay, so our central nervous system is made up of two important parts, na the brain and then our spinal cord. Okay, so let's start with our brain. Okay, so the brain, it weighs about 1.5 kilograms na ang human brain natin. And it is enclosed in a bony structure we call that the skull or the cranium. So since yung brain natin, it acts as the central processing center na nag-oversee ng lahat ng processes ng organ system, our learning, our reasoning, our memory. So it requires large and constant energy supply. So at any time, yung brain activity natin, it requires about 20% of, or it consumes about 20% of the total oxygen, and 15% of the glucose. And tutor Easter, a little bit trivia lang na in just 5 minutes na mawala ng oxygen level ang brain natin, it can cause permanent brain damage.
Brain damage,
okay.
Yes.
Yes, okay, ganun lang.
Comatose, yan.
Yes, ganun lang kabilis, no? Kasi sobrang dami niyang ina-handle, so kailangan niya talaga constant and very large supply of energy.
Okay, so Katrina, ito ay irreversible brain damage. So hindi na may
Permanent brain damage na, no, Tutor Easter. Okay, so anatomically our brain could be divided into four brain, midbrain, and then the hindbrain. So let's see the structure. So let's start with the forebrain. So the forebrain, we have the cerebrum, the thalamus, and then the hypothalamus. Okay, this one. So the thalamus is located between our cerebrum and the midbrain. So this one is the midbrain. And this acts as the central relay station that processes the information and relay it to our cerebrum. Okay, so dahil nakikita natin siya at the middle, okay, so yan yung ating relay station. Next, we have the hypothalamus. And the hypothalamus is about just an almond size, no? And it lies below our thalamus. So it acts now or plays a vital role in linking or connecting our nervous system and our endocrine system. So na-maintain ng ating katawan yung homeostasis because of the hypothalamus. If you still remember our discussion during the first week wherein we discussed reproduction, 'di ba, yung production natin ng sperm cell, yung production natin ng egg cell is regulated by hormone. And saan yun nakikita? Sa hypothalamus of the brain. Okay, so aside from that, no, the hypothalamus also regulate the temperature, the heart rate, water balance, the blood pressure, along with hunger and thirst. Okay, napakadaming ginagawa ni hypothalamus. Okay, so next, major region also of the forebrain is the cerebrum. And the cerebrum controls the qualities of the mind, our personality, our intelligence, our learning, perception, and the emotion. Ayan, mga pinakita natin kanina. And it could be divided into two hemispheres. And so, ito meron siyang denoted by two colors, the pink and the blue one, which these two hemispheres are interconnected with nerve fiber. We call that the corpus callosum. So our brain, although it participates, itong two hemispheres na to, although it participates in most of the brain function, meron silang specialization. Okay, so for example, in most people, yung left brain or yung left hemisphere natin, it is associated with the speech, with our language skills, with our mathematical ability, with reasoning. Whereas yung right hemisphere naman natin specializes in musical and artistic abilities, our spatial activity, yan, the insight, holistic thought, 3D forms, and then also the left hand control. Okay, so magka-alternate nga daw yan, di ba? The right brain or the right hemisphere controls the left hand control, and then the left hemisphere controls the right hand. Okay. All right.
Diba, Tutor Tin, na may interpreting of the signals.
Yes. Okay. And then our cerebrum, it is covered pa with what we call the cerebral cortex, and it can be divided furthermore. We have the frontal lobe. Ayan. So, ano to, favorite kong ipa-ano to sa mga students natin. We have the frontal, the parietal, the temporal, and then the occipital. Okay. Yeah, si frontal could be found in the front of the brain over the eyes. Ayan, dito nga siya, no? So, this contains now what we call the olfactory bulb, which processes smell. Okay, so kung ano man yung maamoy natin, and then it will be processed there. Ay, amoy yan ng paborito kong ulam. Ay, amoy yan ng nanay ko. Okay, di ba? So, magsisignal yan sa ating, yan, in this specific part, the frontal lobe. The frontal lobe, aside from the olfactory bulb, it also contains the motor cortex, which is important in implementing movement or planning. And then we have next, the parietal lobe, which is on top, yan, on top of the brain. So, it is involved in speech and also in reading. And also, it process in the somatosensation and proprioception. So, ano ba ibig sabihin yan? Okay, so the somatosensation, like the perception of pain, pressure, heat, cold, okay. And then, yung proprioception is how the parts of the body are oriented in space. Okay. So, next we have our occipital. Yan, we can find this at the back of the brain, and very delicate yan. It is primarily involved in vision. So, like the olfactory, when you say vision, una, we see. And then we recognize, and then we identify it in the visual world. So, let's say we see something red, and we recognize it's a fruit. Okay, and then we identify, this fruit now is an apple. Okay, so maraming pinagdadaanan, hindi lang basta vision, no? Kailangan ma-recognize and then ma-i-process natin. Then we have here the temporal. Yan, nandito siya sa side, no? Ang ating temporal, which located at the base and then base of the brain and by our ears. So a primary function niya, it's involved in processing and also interpreting the sound. So same thing with vision, so may maririnig tayo and then it will be processed. So let's say this is we hear a music or a sound. So we recognize the voice is coming from our teacher or our friend. Okay. So yan pinaprocess in our temporal lobe. And so it also contains ang ating hypocamus or hippocampus. It's a Greek term for seahorse, which is for memory formation. Sa ating mga memories, childhood memories, or short or long-term memory. Okay, so let's go now to brainstem. Okay, so the mid parts, and the mid parts of the brain, or the midbrain, and then the hindbrain makes up now the brainstem. Okay, so let's start with the medulla oblongata. So this one, it regulates the breathing, the blood pressure, and the heart rate. Okay, so nandito si medulla oblongata. Okay, just below the pons. And ayan, katabi ni ating cerebrum. Si pons, which means bridge, is above the medulla. So it connects the midbrain and ating medulla oblongata. That's the brainstem. Okay, so another part of the brainstem is what you call the cerebellum. sa Rebellium. Okay, so it's the largest part, this one is the largest part of the hindbrain, and it controls the posture and balance. So itong cerebrum natin, no, we can do a lot of things, let's say tying our shoes by this part of the brain. So napaka-importante nitong occipital region natin, yung back of the brain, kasi ayan, maraming activities na kinokontrol. Okay, so let's have here the different sizes of the brain ng mammals. But compared to the other vertebrates, no, Tutor Easter, yung mammals have the largest brain as compared to this body size. If we try to compare it with the reptiles, specifically alligator, yung brain ng alligator, if we look at the alligator, malaki siya, di ba? Pero ang brain niya, it's just about 1.5 teaspoon. Ganun lang kaliit. And if we try to observe then the evolution, it's something to do how complex or yung the size ng brain is related also sa behavior or sa skills na nagagawa ng isang organism. Okay, so as you can see here from the rat, okay, we have next would be the cat, the rabbit, chimpanzee, sheep, human, dolphin, and yung largest nga na meron tayo na mammal na meron na largest size of the brain mammals, which is the whales. Okay, so aside from the size, ang tinitingnan din dyan is yung infoldings. We call that the gyrus and sulcus, yung mga infoldings na yan, no, that increases the surface area. So the more infoldings that we have, as you can see yan, sa dolphin, napakadami, sa human, but compare sa rat, sa rabbit, and sa cat, mas onti lang infoldings nila, the gyrus and sulcus. So, isa din yan sa mga tinitingnan, no, kung gaano ka-complex yung ginagawa ng mga mammals or ng certain vertebrate. Okay, so let's go now to the spinal cord. So, ang ating spinal cord is just a tube that emerges right below the base of the brain. Okay, so it extends, and so from our nape going to the back of the body hanggang dito. So yung spinal cord natin can be divided into cervical, okay, thoracic, lumbar, and sacral, which is also covered with a bony structure called the vertebral column. So it tracks of nerve fiber, the spinal cord tracks of nerve fibers that allow two-way conduction of nerve impulses, the afferent and efferent. So mamaya didiscuss natin yan. Pero as we observe, no, Tutor Easter, our brain and spinal cord, these two important organs are covered entirely with rigid solid bone, di ba? As we compare it with other organs in the body, ang ating heart, ang lungs natin, it is also covered with bones, yung rib cage, pero there are spaces. Pero itong, if we try to compare it with our brain, di ba? It is entirely covered, no? Parang walang portion of the brain that is exposed. And also, sa vertebral column naman natin, there are spaces, okay? Pero covered pa rin si spine. So, napaka galing ng pagkakadesign sa atin, no? Even at the microscopic level, we can see that yung pinaka-important part or organelle na meron ng cell, it is covered twice or double membrane siya. Yun yung ating nucleus and mitochondria kasi may DNA. And as we go, no, habang pumunta tayo from cell tissue organs, nakikita natin yung mga organs na important kasi they are also surrounded or enclosed entirely in solid rigid bone. Okay, so yan, ganun naman tayo, di ba? Humans, kapag mahalaga sa atin, we tend to cover it up. Pinagpakatago-tago pa natin yan, di ba? So, ganun
naman. In order to protect, Tutor Tina.
Yes, protection
talaga. Because they are vital organs.
Okay. Yeah, so what covers this too, we call that the meninges. So as you can see, this is the skull. And then we have here the dura mater. May ilang layers pa siya, di ba? Dura mater, the arachnoid, and then the pia mater. Bago pa bago pa yung pinaka-brain. So, ganun kakapal. May skull na nga, and then we have the meninges. And also, meron ding cerebrospinal fluid sa atin ng mga vertebral column. Okay, so we this two yung pinaka-important in the central nervous system are covered or protected. Okay, so let's go now to the next division, which is the peripheral nervous system. So we are done with brain and spinal cord. So ano naman ang included in the peripheral nervous system? So our peripheral nervous system is a network of nerves spread across the body. And we have 43 pairs of nerves in total. So out of that 43, we have 12 cranial nerves. So yung 12 na yun, yung cranial nerves, it emerges from the base of the brain. So pagka, when you go to ano no to science-related courses, mga BioStar students, papakabisado sa inyo yung ano ba yung 12 cranial nerves na yan, di ba? And then, we have 31 pairs of spinal nerves. Kaya naman siya tinawag na spinal nerves because it arise from the segments of the spinal cord and innervates in the trunk and limbs. So, ayan, kung makikita natin sa picture, so we have, okay, dito from the spinal cord, so these are the spinal nerves. So ito naman, yung from the base of the brain, these are cranial nerves. Okay, so let's go now. So neurons, this is the basic unit of our nervous system. So the nerve cell transmit electrical signals to the brain. So we have different parts of our neurons. The first one is what we call the dendrites. And if you try to observe in the picture, these are short branch extensions that transmit information from the other dendrites or from the other neurons, okay, no, towards now the cell body. So what is now the cell body? The cell body contains not just the nucleus, it contains the mitochondria, it contains the ribosome that produce protein, okay. So what else? We have the axon. So, si axon naman conducts nerve impulses away from the cell body. So, si dendrites taga-receive. So, coming from the other dendrites towards the cell body, si axon naman from the cell body away, okay, or coming like going to different parts of the body. Okay, then our axon can be covered or merong parts of the axon that is not covered with this one. We call that the myelin sheath. So, ano ang function ng ating myelin sheath, it insulates the axon to speed up the impulse conduction. Pagka merong myelin sheath, mas mabilis yung transmission or pag-conduct ng mga impulses, no, from one neuron to another. So as you can see here, if you try to compare a neuron sa isang wire, so yung wire na covered with plastic ba yun or ano, yun yung myelin sheath. Okay, kapag binalatan natin yung wire, diba? So kasi nagbibring din sila ng electrical signals, okay, ito yung part na yun. So si myelin sheath, yan, it covers the axon. Okay, so we have our neurons could be categorized into three. The sensory neurons, and then the interneurons, and then the motor neurons. Okay, ano-ano bang ginagawa ng mga ito? So, sa sensory neurons, it's a neuron that receives impulses from, let's say, from our skin. I'll give you an example. Let's say we touch something hot, okay, and then these sensory neurons will send signal to the spinal nerves, going to the spinal cord and up to the brain, and then the brain will process it, and then the brain will send a response going now to our motor neurons. So ano-ano ba yung klaseng sensory, mga senses na pwede nating maramdaman, no? So we have mechanoreceptor in terms of touch, we have the thermoreceptor in terms of temperature, hot or cold man yan, nociceptor pain, so when we touch something sharp, okay, chemoreceptors from the different chemicals, oxygen, glucose, or electrolytes. So, dadaan siya sa inter, when we say inter, this means between, okay, between these two neurons. This receives information from the sensory neurons, process it, and then generate message to the motor neuron. So, si motor neuron naman will create the response. Create muscle contraction or create muscle inhibition. So let's say you touch something hot, si motor, pagka process kay brain, ang sabi ni brain, you withdraw it. Okay, alisin mo yung kamay mo. Okay, so the motor neuron will give the response. Okay, so i-let go mo yung cup na mainit or alisin mo yung kamay mo dyan. It's because it's hot. Okay, so let's see, ganito siya, nag-work. Okay, from the sensory neuron, going to our interneuron, this will be processed. And then, magbibigay ng respond ngayon. Ano ba yung respond? Okay, going to that certain parts of the body. Let's say, itong arm. And as you can see, itong bata, ano, and I think nakahawak siya ng something hot. Kasi parang stove to. Okay, so, she tend to withdraw or alisin yung kamay niya dun sa source of pain or heat or kung ano man. Okay. So our peripheral nervous system could be further subdivided into two. We have the sensory somatic nervous system, which control voluntary control of the skeletal muscles. So this one, when you say voluntary control, you are conscious about it, diba? So alam mo when to withdraw yourself or alisin mo yung kamay mo or i-bend mo yan or i-extend mo. And we have the autonomic nervous system, which controls bodily functions without our conscious control, or we call that the involuntary movement. Okay, so ano-ano pa ba yung mga kinokontrol ni autonomic nervous system? Because si sensory somatic, most of the control sa skeletal muscle natin. So si autonomic nervous system controls the following: our different glands such as the liver, the kidneys, and of course the skin. Okay, so we cannot control the function of the kidney, right? This is done automatically for us, di ba? Kaya nga siya involuntary. And then the autonomic nervous system controls also the smooth muscle, such as the lungs, our intestine, our stomach, and then the urinary bladder. So it also controls the cardiac muscle, which is the heart. So these things are involuntary, meaning we cannot control the beating of the heart, the digestion, the absorption. Okay, so these are done automatically for us. Kaya autonomic nervous system. Okay, and our autonomic nervous system could be further subdivided into sympathetic nervous system and then the parasympathetic nervous system. So if you kung narinig niyo na to, no, the sympathetic nervous system is for the fight or flight response. Why? Because it dominates under the stress, including emergencies. Ano yung mga situation? So let's say you will have a presentation of your thesis defense, diba? So ito yung mga nagkakaroon tayo ng we are under stress or under emergency, or let's say nasa sunog, diba? Naiwan ka sa isang bahay na nasusunog. Okay. Ano ba ang mga nangyayari? So let's have here. So ano ang mga nangyayari? We have dilation of our pupil, inhibition of salivation, okay? Accelerates heartbeat, bumibilis ang tibok ng puso, nagdadilate ang ating bronchi. Inhibits digestion. Ito yung sinasabi natin, no, Tutor Easter, na butterflies in our stomach. Alam niyo ba yung idiomatic expression na yun? So it's because nagsisecrete ng cortisol yung inaang hormone na cortisol yung ating katawan, and nagko-constrict ngayon yung mga blood vessels sa stomach, and nagko-contract yung stomach. So parang meron kang feeling na there are butterflies in the stomach. Di ba kapag under stress ka, parang hirap kumain. Also, it stimulates the glucose release, stimulate epinephrine and norepinephrine, inhibit peristalsis and secretion, and relaxes the bladder. While our parasympathetic naman returns the body into the normal heart rate and respiration slow and digestion resumes. Okay, so ang tinatawag naman natin ng ating parasympathetic nervous system, which is the rest and digest. Okay, so but this, yes.
Ito yung dahilan kung bakit, di ba, nabubuhat ng tao yung mga bagay kapag nasusunog, di ba, may sunog.
Yes.
Nabubuhat kapag yung mga hindi nga nabubuhat kasi because okay. Of the fight or flight response.
Yes, adrenaline response na rin. Nag nagse-secrete din ng hormone ng adrenaline, and then yun nga yung mga nangyayari no, nag tumataas ang nag-increase ang heart rate, nagko-contract ating mga blood vessel in the stomach, and also yun no, manawawala tayo ng ganang kumain, parang gano'n no, during stress. And also yung sympathetic din natin, yun din yung mga nangyayari over sa mga crushes, 'di ba, sa mga senior high school student
ang
natin,
yung kapag crush, 'di ba?
Crush, oo, 'di ba? May kakaroon ng crush. Kasi tataas ang heart rate, tapos 'yan, kaya nagtatawag na ay nagba-blush ka. Okay, kasi nga nagkakaroon.
Pwede na eh, doon din sa ano, kapag nakita niya yung terror na teacher, kinatatakutan yung teacher, sympathetic nervous system 'yon.
Yes.
Kasi na si teacher, yan na si teacher, 'di ba?
May mga ganong effect. So, in terms of parasympathetic, it's the other way around. Our pupil constrict and it stimulates salivation. Okay, nag-slow ang ating heartbeat, constriction of the bronchi in the lungs. It stimulates digestion, bile release, and also it stimulates peristalsis and secretion. And then this is the time that nagko-contract naman ang ating bladder. Okay, but this is the yin and yang process of our body. Marami pang actually yin and yang processes sa ating katawan, no? And this works simultaneously. So hindi there are moments lang na tumataas si sympathetic over parasympathetic, but it doesn't mean na nag-i-stop, no. It's actually working, no, simultaneously. Okay, so what about now in terms of our invertebrates? So we have Cnidaria or ating mga jellyfish. So they lack the true nervous system. Wala naman talaga silang true nervous system. They don't have brain at all, ang ating mga Cnidaria, but instead they have their nerve, we call that their nerve cells, which is in a separate one, no? Kasi wala talaga naman silang brain. But in our echinoderms, ang example natin ng echinoderms, yan yung ating mga sea star, they have the nerve cell that are bundled also in a fiber. They call it also nerves. But ang ating mga flatworms, yung planaria, they have the central nervous system and also the peripheral nervous system. In terms of insect, they are more complex compared to other to cnidarians or echinoderms because they have the brain. Okay, and then meron din silang, but this one, oh, found in the ventral region. So ito yung kanilang brain and then the spinal cord. Okay. Then we have the octopus. Okay, aside from the brain and then the nerves and then the ganglia, they also have the eyes that is very similar to vertebrates. And of course, ayan na yung ating human. Okay, so let's go now to plants. Ayan. So ano ba ang meron sa plants? So our plants do not have nervous system at all. They don't have brain, they don't have nerves, okay? But they can sense the changes in the environment and respond to it. Okay, so what are the processes na involved? So we have here the presence of photoreceptor. So yung plants natin, yung plant cells ay merong photoreceptors which detects the quality and the quantity of light na na-absorb nila. So look at the example. We call that the phototropism. So it is the directional growth of the plant specifically, no, in response to light. So as you can see here in the picture, kung nasaan ang light, okay, no, it moves towards the source of light. Okay, ito sa ating plant. So that's the positive phototropism. Meron din namang negative na kung nasaan yung source of light, nagtatago naman sila din, yeah? Such as the root. Okay. Next, we have the gravitropism. Okay, this one is the directional growth in response to gravity. So this is very important, no, in terms of the plant, kasi ito yung direction ng ating root growth. Okay, so as you can see here, meron tayong positive and negative gravitropism. Asan yung positive natin? Kung nasaan yung direction of gravity, which is yung root, Okay, yung pull of gravity, ganun siya nag-grow. While the negative response naman to gravitropism is yung stem growth. Okay, kasi upward siya. And even if you try to change the orientation ng plant, no, kahit sabihin natin, ma'am, kasi po nakaganon yung pot, eh, kahit i-sideways pa natin siya, then yung direction pa rin ng root will be, kahit sideways na, no, towards pa rin talaga sa source of or pull of gravity. Okay, and then we have here the thigmotropism or the directional response to touch or solid structure. Okay, so meron tayo ditong tendril. Ito yung halaman and then itong parang thread-like structure is what you call the tendril. And if it touch, no, something solid, dun siya kumakapit at nag-roll. Yan, ganun yung direction ng kanyang growth. Itong part na yan ng plant, we call that tendril. Okay, so aside from that, no, aside from the response to light, to gravity, so our plant cells are also capable of generating electrical impulses. And marami ng videos na pwede nating mapanood and ma-measure, no, how really the plants produce or generate electrical impulses. Same thing with our animal cells. And we call that the action potential. So we have here the Mimosa pudica or also known as makahiya, no, sa atin. Okay, so nami-measure yan na once na magkaroon ng connection or yan, matouch lang yung certain, even the tip of this, magkakaroon or ma-measure na agad yung increase ng electrical signal, no? And then, ito na yung mangyayari. Magko-close na siya. We also have the Venus flytrap. Meron tayo ditong mga hair-like structure na
sensitive.
Okay, very sensitive. Pero ang galing, Tutor Easter, no? Kasi, let's say, parang nagbibilang siya eh. Let's say, one time, meron, may ma-touch mo tong certain part na yung hair-like structure na yun. Hindi pa agad siya magpo-close. Parang bibilangin pa niya ng ilang time to make sure na meron na talagang laman yung loob. Okay, no? Kasi, photosynthesis pa rin naman ang main source of food ni Venus flytrap. So, yung mga excess na lang na carnivores, yung same thing with the insect or this one, parang snail to, ano na lang, additional minerals and supplements na lang siya. And then, napakatagal kasi bago mag-open up ulit si Venus flytrap. So, hindi naman kada sense niya, no, ng anything, ay magko-close agad siya. No? It will take time, no, para to make sure na, ay, meron na talagang lang. Because 24 hours to 48 hours bago mag-open up ulit si Venus flytrap. Eh napakataas, no, na ma-measure talaga yung increase ng electrical signal na kapag nagalaw natin tong mga hair-like structures. Okay, so there you go. So to summarize everything in terms of our nervous system ng vertebrates, we have central nervous system that is made up of brain and spinal cord. We have the peripheral nervous system which we had the motor neurons and then the sensory neurons, and then it can be further subdivided into somatic nervous system and autonomic nervous system. Our autonomic nervous system could be subdivided even more by the sympathetic or the fight or flight response, and then the parasympathetic, which is the rest and digest. Okay, so there you go. So for our psych career, we have here psychiatrist and neurologist. So, ano ba ang difference ng dalawa? So, both of them diagnoses, treat, and prevent mental illnesses. But, si psychiatrist, more on the emotional disorder, while si neurologist focuses on the specific nervous system, such as the brain, kung may problem ba in terms of the brain, spinal cord, and different nerves. So, si psychiatrist, ang mga binibigay niyang treatment, counseling, behavioral therapy, or psychiatric medication, while si neurologist naman, okay, so could be rehabilitation, yung mga rehab, or medication talaga, or at the worst, operation. Diba? But both of them are medical doctors. You need to have a preparatory course for medicine if you want to be a neurologist or psychiatrist, and you have to take medicine, no, maging MD muna before you go to specialization. no, ng pagiging neurologist and psychiatrist. So I hope no mga few years, mga ilang years, mga 8 years we have BioStar student na babalik sa atin, okay, na isa na silang psychiatrist or neurologist.
I'm sure, okay. Tito Tina, marami dyan ang nag-aasam na maging isang doktor.
Yes, marami tayong student. Okay, so let's check kung meron silang natutunan sa ating discussion. Let's have our knowledge check.
Okay, dito na tayo sa knowledge check, mga BioStar students. So for number one, the human nervous system comprises the A, central nervous and peripheral nervous system, B, central nervous and somatic nervous system, C, sympathetic nervous system and parasympathetic nervous system, D, autonomic nervous system and somatic nervous system. BioStar students, please type the letter and your the number and the letter. So we have an answer here, Tutor Tina, letter A. Is it letter A?
Okay, correct. It's central nervous system and peripheral nervous system. Let's have number two, Tutor Easter.
Okay, number two, preparing the body for fight or flight response during threatening situations is the role of the A, parasympathetic nervous system, B, sympathetic nervous system, C, afferent nervous system, D, somatic nervous system. Number two, what is your answer, BioStar student? Is it a letter A, B, C, or D? So we have an answer here, Tutor Tina, letter B from Mark Allen. Okay, very
okay,
good.
Okay, it's correct. Let's have number three.
The neuron that receives incoming stimuli are called A, soma, B, axon, C, dendrites, D, neurolemmas. Okay, what is our answer, BioStar students, for number three? We have an answer here, letter C. Is it letter C, Tutor Tina?
Okay, correct. Dendrites. Let's have number four.
Number four, this is the term used to refer to plant movement in response to a stimulus. A, tropism. B, signal. C, senses. D, nerve. Okay, what is your answer in number four, BioStar students? Is it letter A, B, C, D? So we have an answer here, Tutor Tina from Elena. Letter A.
Okay, it's letter A, tropism. And we have number five.
Number five, which sense is utilized in thigmotropic response? A, sight, B, smell, C, taste, D, touch. So what is our answer, BioStar students, for number five? A, B, C, or D? So we have an answer here, Tutor Tina, from Care Cantero, letter D.
Okay, so
ang gagaling nila, Tutor Tina.